So I've been thinking really hard lately about this issue, the phasing out of 410A and introduction of the new refrigerants, which are classification A2L. And what does A2L mean to the regular homeowner? That's debatable. I think it means a lot. It's a significant change to what options homeowners have. The government has mandated that the efficiencies and the climate impact of 410A just didn't reach the levels that they expected to. So they're going on to the next level of refrigerant. And good or bad, we will see. But part of this is they are semi-flammable. An A2L category means that these refrigerants are semi-flammable. The good side is you don't need as much refrigerant and they work down to a much colder temperature in delivering heat. The bad side is since it is semi-flammable, there's requirements to have leak detection devices on the equipment. It seems simple and everybody thinks it's going to be fine. If 40 years in the HVAC industry has taught me anything, anytime they introduce a technological change, there can be side effects and implications. It comes to mind when they put low water cutoffs as mandatory. Great concept, great idea. They work great now, but the first couple of years, they were a nightmare for contractors and homeowners alike with shutting systems down, false alarms, false cutoffs that would turn your heat off in the middle of the night, and you got a brand new system, you're calling a contractor upset, and we got to send somebody out there in the middle of the night to reset it. And there's just numerous occasions of when good intentions were there, but we're forced with these arbitrary timelines, and we had to implement these technologies before the kinks were worked out. And I'm afraid that we're on the verge of that. Unfortunately, we're here at the end of October and time's running out because all these rules go into effect at the end of this year. And manufacturers doing what they probably should have started phasing out the manufacturing and building 410A equipment. We're starting to see shortages. And again, back to what does this mean to you, the homeowner, our customers? I just feel obligated that we should bring this information to you so you can make a decision that's right for you, your family, your budget. Do you wait for when your system is ready to go and you need to buy these new A2L systems, which are either R32 refrigerant or 454B, or do you take action now, save money, avoid the different aspects of the new technology, and be proactive and put in a 410A system? Or you're in the third category, you really don't care, you got too much stuff going on in your life and you don't want to know. If you're in either of the first two categories, you should click on the link and learn more, or you should call the office, schedule a call, schedule an appointment, and have one of our comfort advisors or service technicians come out and talk to you, or just get on the phone call. We're here to help, we're here to give you options, and whatever you do, we just want to make sure we get you this information and you do what's right for your family and for your budget and the timeline of the age of your system and the dependability. If you're having problems or you've had problems in the past, it may be in your best interest to look into it a little more right now and decide if it makes sense to install a 410A system now, or if it makes sense to wait until you have to do something and go with a A2L, R32, or 454B system. It's your decision, your option. Our job as your contractor is to just educate and inform you so you can make a choice. The worst thing we do is not bring this to your attention and you find out by accident or after it's too late, and we don't want that to happen.